Hey, how you doing today? I'm not a doomsdayist, I'm not a prepper, not a survivalist, any of that crap. But I wanted a pair of night vision, something. A couple weeks ago, me and the channel mascot Leo were outside. He dragged me over by the fence line. Took my ultrafire flashlight. If you haven't seen that video, watch that. That flashlight's amazing. Shined it out in front of us. Excuse me, about 20-25 yards in front of us, it's a huge black bear. From its rear hind corner to its front hind shoulder, not counting its head sticking out another 2 feet, its body was about 6 feet long. This was a big bear, one of the biggest bears I've seen in a long time. At least 350 pounds. And he spooked us. You know, black bear maulings, attacks, are more vicious, they say, than brown bears or grizzlies, so. Anyways, I wanted something that I could carry. This also has a helmet mount, which I put on there to show you. So I guess if you had some sort of helmet, you could attach a helmet. The downfall is, where this mount goes onto there, screws longer than dead, there's no O-ring. There's no weather sealing. You can see down into the camera body. So if you got moisture ingress in around there, you would probably ruin the unit. I'm not sure that this thing is totally waterproof, water resistant. There's no IP rating whatsoever on it. It's basically, you can see the camera in there. Has some sort of IR filter removed. But if you turn the turn the knob, which is right there, here, click on. There's a digital screen right there, like a little computer screen. So the camera senses what it's picking up. There's also, if I turn that knob up a little bit higher, let me shut the light off on the camera. Okay, anyways, I guess Leo's going to photobomb the video. Hope you guys don't mind. It's my lovable little guy. He's got to go everywhere with me. Kind of like my friend Todd, KB7RQQ, his cat, Ollie. Always got to sit on his lap, so. They're like family. But anyways, it does work. It does work most impressive. I'm not sure if that's the same thing as a tripod mount, because I do have a couple monopods around here. It does look like there's some sort of metal insert in there, which is good. It's a cheap nylon housing, like a Krylon type housing. It's not, well, this part here and here is aluminum. I don't know what else is metal in the thing. The battery compartment's right there. I got two Duracell power boost batteries in there, which seem to be powering it perfectly fine. There's a sacrificial lens filter you can put on the top of it, kind of like in cameras. Just a filter that goes over top, so if you're going to damage something, you damage the filter and not your actual glass lens. Ruin that, scratch out, you're kind of SOL. But anyways, it does come with a little J-arm. They mount it on like a bump helmet, something like that. And it comes with a little cloth. Molly Pell's pouch. Inside of there, there is another screw for this J-arm. I'm not sure why. Unless that C-clip fell out of there and you lost it or something, but maybe to make an improvised mount, mount it to something else, I don't know. So, anyways, got this from a guy out there in Kansas off eBay. Well, let me shut it off before the battery goes dead. And it works quite well. So if you need night vision just for surveilling a field or not running into a bear, we ran into a skunk before out there, had to bounce off my damn leg. You know, this might be just a thing to look ahead of you. You're out camping. You know, I know some people are into Bigfoot hunting. Yeah, here you go, Leo. Check it out. You know, there's a whole bunch of different uses and application for it. This is the Canis Latrans. ET Dragon makes one. Find those on Amazon. And if you get lucky, find an old used one. The Bushnell Sentry was basically the same thing. Which leads me to believe that maybe the Chinese manufacturer that made it for Bushnell kept the molding, the casting, all the parts, Bushnell said, okay, well, contract, would you make a million of these things? So the contractor, instead of making a million, they run off 2 million, 3 million, 5 million. Those Chinese men are sneaky, anything to make a buck. It's not bad. There are some limitations. Infrared illuminator might give you away, but who the hell is going to see that little tiny dot 50, 100 yards away? The night vision. You know, it's good. It's sharp. You focus the front. At least this is what I did to focus it. Focus the front and focus the back a little bit to bring it into focus. So every time you focus at something different distance, you're going to have to readjust. But I focused about 100 yards, and as long as you're just zooming across a field, everything seemed to be good. Only until I came in and like focused at something 20 yards away, then I had to readjust it. So, anyways, need some night vision. I guess this is a good, safe alternative. Canis Latrans PVS14. It's not a true phosphorus tube. This is digital. It's basically like a closed circuit TV camera. We'll get into that. So, battery runs off two AA's. This is the viewing distance, 200 meters, 600 feet. How far are you going to really shine? You know, immediate threat, like the bear, we'll get into the video. It's like 60 feet away from us. I wish I could have seen him 100 yards, 100 feet away from him. But anyways, here's the information, and let's proceed with the video. I got the light off on the camera, but the problem is the screen's right. There's no way to adjust that, so it's overpowering my camera to see through that. I look through that with the naked eye, it's very sharp. So anyways, I'm going to zoom out and see what we can do. I don't have any infrared glow on. Let me hit the knob. Well, I can't do it while you're on, but no illuminator. I'm going to report back, see how far we can actually maybe see. Okay, the most I think I can see, there's a power outlet over there, probably about 40 yards from me. Tree line. I don't think the camera can see it. Goes between 40 and 50 yards. That's all I can make out, even with that infrared illuminator on. But I got some street lights behind me, so they're kind of like overpowering and washing out this thing from the side, so it's not a good thing. It's overwashing the light. Maybe I should try to zoom down the road and see how far I can see. Speed limit sign probably 80 yards away from me. I don't know if the... I think the camera shows it kind of like a yellowish reflection because I got the parking lights on. Okay, one thing I can tell you after wearing them, even only maybe 5 minutes, I got it set up for the right eye. Just been hand-holding it for this test. Is that when I remove this from my eye, my right eye is washed out. Looks like I looked at the sun, seen a bunch of spots. I lose my natural light vision capability naturally in that eye. Left eye is perfectly fine. If I close my right eye, look through my left eye, I'm fine. So that's a downfall of digital night vision. I'm not sure if it happens with the phosphorus tubes or not. But at least with this thing, I'm losing my natural light vision ability with my eye when I remove my eye from that lens, or shall we say a camera screen. So get your seal approval, bud. Yeah, you like that? Okay, he's like, he approves.